freedom.
A lot of constitutionalists look at the growing entitlement programs and wonder if those are really constitutional per se. And it's also, right. I mean, relating entitlement spending to our generation possibly having to pay for that.
Right.
You see a possible correlation there?
Well, absolutely. It's with any issue, quite honestly. Any issue that pertains to the federal government, you have to find backing in the Constitution. The Constitution was meant to limit the federal government, not limit people, not limit the states, limit the federal government. So any positions that we're taking when it comes to federal issues need to have constitutional backing, and we need to see how that relates. Otherwise, it needs to go down to the state, the local level, and the people. But to understand that is where the only rights in federal government lie. It's not that the Constitution leaves us powerless. It leaves the federal government a lot less powerless than the people. And I think that's something that no matter what issue it may be, we need to find is, does the Constitution have anything to say about
this?
And
do you think, I heard you talking about politicians, people were asking about, you know, what candidate you want to support. And you
right.
said, basically, you can't find any politician that lives to those hardcore principles.
You know, and I'm not saying I've carefully examined
right,
every
right,
politician
sure,
in the world,
sure.
but absolutely, at this point, I have not found someone that I can back 100% with those ideas. That I think, and quite honestly, sometimes when you get in the mix of things and in the spirit of day-to-day life trying to get things done, sometimes people tend to put those things by the wayside and compromise to the fact that they say, well, in order to get something done here, we may just have to ignore that this time. And so I see that happening sometimes, but I'll continue to look at what politicians are doing and see if there are those that are respectful of the Constitution and those founding principles.
Yeah, well, we certainly appreciate that here at the Foundation, and especially those constitutional principles and values. And going back to the debt question, what do you see that, especially for our generation, you know, you're 18 years old, I'm
right.
21, well, you're going to have a lot of money in
right.
on our hands, right?
Right, and you know, honestly, since I haven't gone to college, since I haven't had all those economic
yeah.
courses and those sorts of things,
sure.
the only thing that I can compare it to is anybody's budget, any household, any person. And growing up, you know, my parents taught us about budgeting, about expenses, about whatever it may be, about balancing your checkbook, that sort of thing. And that's the only thing I can compare it to. And to see that my parents taught me to have more responsibility monetarily than the government does is kind of scary. That we need to understand that those basic fundamentals of economics and of a budget is that you don't spend more than you have, and you don't cut the necessities first, you cut those extra things first. You keep the necessities there and balance it from there. And I think it'll be very interesting to get deeper into the economics of everything, but that's the number one principle that people need to realize.
I mean, it seems like a novel concept for a lot of politicians in Washington, D.C., unfortunately,
right.
balancing a checkbook.
Exactly.